Hi my friends and welcome to my new tutorial. I am SV and today we will do this composition. So today I will show you how to use a displacer tools, how to create a displacement map. Additionally, I will show you very interesting plugin for Cinema 4D. Name of this plugin Forester. Together with this plugin we create some trees and grass. Additionally, I will show you how to create a redshift sun and redshift sky. And finally, we will do some small production in Adobe After Effects. So, if you are ready, let's start! Okay, in beginning we are going in Adobe After Effects. I create a new composition and give size for this composition 2000 pixels for 2000 pixels. I need it only one segment, like this. It's enough. Okay, now we are going and add new solid. Just standard black color. And we apply to this solid like some gradient. I will use red giant text gradient. Okay. On the settings of this gradient, we are going to type and change this to square. Going to colors, and we will use only two colors: color number one and color number two. Three we no need. As you can see, this plugin can add up to six different colors. Okay, color number one will be almost white, but just 90% coming to gray, like this. And color number two will be full black, and increase a position 100%, like this. Okay, very good. Now we will add additionally one effect. Name of this effect pasteurize, maybe on the English little bit different, but pasteurize I think is correct. Okay, we will apply, going to levels and increase, I don't know, maybe 20 levels. We will do like this, you see, like a pixels. Very good. What we will do now, we create a new solid and size will be 2000 up to only 100, like this line. We create one more solid and change 100 up to 2000. We will do some cross. So now we apply to this cross gradient ramp. Okay, we apply here and we apply here. What setting I will use for gradient ramp? First of all, it will be radial. And now we will make it little bit check. Okay. Center will be white. I think I need swap color. Okay, very good. Yeah, like this. So will be 0, will be 1000, will be 50. Okay, I will do like this. And now we are change the settings for second one also. I don't know, something like this. Should be radial. Center and center. Okay, very nice. So just apply exactly of the middle of this layer. Yeah, this is very important. Middle and middle. Okay, very good. And white color I will change also for little bit gray, about 90% of gray here and about 90% of gray here. Very good. So I have like this picture. What is this? This is displacement map for our Cinema 4D. So now we are going to render quote and save it like a PNG and somewhere on the desktop. Save and render. Very good. Now we are going to our Cinema 4D. First of all, I will create a plane. For this plane, I will apply size 1000 up to 1000, and I will apply a displacer tool. Make it like a child for this plane. So, going to displacer tool and on the shadings, and inside in this area we have to apply our displacement map which we created in Adobe After Effects. So, just push here and open. Now, what we have? Going to object and start increase. We have very interesting something. I don't know what it is, but to see more correct, we have to add more segments to our plane. So it's really more, maybe 500 up to 500. What we have? We have very nice pyramids. You see. I like to add some stairs to this area. How to do it? We're going back to Adobe After Effects. We're going to these areas and apply pasteurize here and maybe increase. You see, yes, coming some lines, maybe 50. We will do too much these steps, and just copy and paste to this area. So again, save. Yes, save. Same area, save. Okay. And what we have here, very good. And just go to displacer, go to shadings, and reload. And now we have ladders. Very good. We are finished with our pyramids. What we will do now? Create some landscape. We have to make a big size, yes, because our pyramids is not small. So I will do approximately 5000 up to 5000, and YX maybe will be 500, like this. Okay, I will do like this. Very nice. So now I have to find some very interesting direction, maybe from somewhere from this area. Oh, first of all, I will pick up my land scale, maybe to this level. Okay, and then I will pick up my pyramid somewhere here. Later we will set up it more correctly. Okay. So maybe somewhere in this place I will create a camera. Okay, very good. Look through the camera, and now we will do some small settings. First of all, I will put somewhere middle, and maybe I will little bit put down and pick up like this. Okay, so we have pyramids, we have some land scale. No, maybe I little bit change the rotation of this camera, maybe like this. Okay, so I like it. Take our pyramids and drag somewhere in this area and put down. Okay, maybe a little bit to forward and put down. So, very good. Try to make a very good. Try to make some render and check what we have. Okay, looks like not so bad. Looks like not so bad. What we will do now? Now we will proceed to our plugin. Name of this plugin: Forester. Forester Rock, Forester Tree, Multicloner, and Multiflora. I already created some shortcut on my toolbar, so I will use from this area. If you haven't like this, you can use from plugin Forester. First of all, I will create a tree. You just push to the tree and you have a tree. There are too much different options. Today I will show you only few of them. First of all, it's tree library. You're going inside and you can see many, many, many different trees. If you push on this tree, you have this tree. Here you have. It's very, very simple to use it. So for my tutorial, I will use Aurelia tree. Aurelia maybe. Go to trees parameters, and very important for us parameter is tree size. So I reduce, I make it really small tree, and put somewhere close to the camera, maybe somewhere here. So now I put camera down, take camera somewhere down. Now I change angle of this camera. Look up. Okay. I don't like position of this. Okay, maybe somewhere closer to me I will use it. Okay, maybe like this. Check. Okay, and you can see, yes, it's already start working. Very good. So what we will do now, we take a tree and put maybe somewhere here. Very good. Now we have to go to render settings. First of all, like usually, I will use redshift and I will use a full HD. Very good. Going to redshift, force enable, take out, system, bucket, increase, make a spiral, and change maybe 4 just for beginning to fast render, just to check how it's working. Okay, very good, it's working. Next parameter what we need in tree parameters, this is render levels. It's how many levels we will see after during rendering. So for a moment we reduce maybe 2 just to increase speed of our render. What we will do now, take tree, hold Ctrl on your keyboard and copy this. Copy and copy. 4 I think will be enough. So we take number 1 and put maybe somewhere here, just pick up. Take this tree and put maybe here. It's absolutely up to you where is you put it. I just show you how it's working, and maybe somewhere on the top. Okay, very good. What you will do now, go to trees and change a seed. Any seed. Just to make these trees a little bit randomized. Okay, very good. What we will do now? Plugins, Forester and Multiflora. I use from my this toolbar area. Multiflora working almost same like a trees. You have too much options, but what we need a Multiflora library. You go inside and you can see too much different libraries, too much different flowers, grasses, everything. I will use this grass, long grass. This will be one, and I will use wild grass. But look, if you push, you will use a material. If you push, you lose your material. To avoid this problem, and as I use a redshift material, so I create a new redshift material, going inside, take texture, and inside in path of texture I just copy texture from Cinema 4D. Just copy and paste in this area and make like diffuse color. Okay, very good. When you finish this is RC, you see redshift. Take it, hold Alt on your keyboard, drag and drop. So now all my this long grass have a redshift material. So now we create one more multiflora and create wild grass. Okay, very strange, not coming. We will try create one more time, sometimes. Okay, maybe we will do it one more time. I don't know what's the problem. Okay, now we have. Now we have. Yeah, sometimes coming problem, but what we can do. Okay, we have long grass and we have wild grass. For wild grass, I will make same options. New redshift material, going inside, take texture, going to this, copy this texture from this area and put inside in redshift. Make like a diffuse color, take it, drag and drop on the original texture. So same we will do for a trees. I take this texture, drag drop, going inside, copy leaves from trees, going to redshift texture and just paste. Very good, I have leaves. Alt on your keyboard, drag and drop. Copy this texture, copy this way, going inside, like this. And finally we will override all our original Cinema 4D textures for our grass and trees, override for a redshift textures. So now we can make some additional options. For example, we can add some specular. I don't know, maybe 0.4 will be good. And for all my leaves, I will use 0.4. For my tree, I use maybe 0.7. Okay, very good. I think this is done. Now we take two our grasses and put close to our tree. For what we need it, just to apply a size. Just to apply size. As you can see, grass have a very big size. So we are going inside, going to global settings, multiflora global and multiflora size. We change it, maybe 0.5. Okay, it's good. Take it and change 0.5. So now I like this size, it looks like natural. And how to make a clone of this grass to our length scale? We cannot use our standard cloner, it's not working properly. But for this Forester plugin, we have some special multi-cloner. Just push this button, take all these grasses and put inside. Also, this multi-cloner work with trees, but as for me, I more like to put trees manually. It's more easy for me, but you can try also use multi-cloner for trees. So going inside to multi-cloner, and inside we have few settings. First of all, distribute on geometry. Push this button. And as you can see, distribution geometry is empty. So inside we have drag and drop our length scale. And coming too much small points. If you take out this, you can see grass. You can see grass. Very good. We have to increase, because if you put down clone count, we have only 100. It's very small. So we will use maybe 10,000. Maybe 10,000. Okay, we have grass. But as you can see, some grass is outside and we cannot see. So we have a filtering. Inside in multi-cloner, we have very nice option filtering, just to reduce loading of your memory. Inside in this filtering, we have very interesting options. Clip to camera. So inside in area, camera link, drag and drop our camera. Like this. Now I show you how it's working from the top view. As you can see, it's coming to stuck. Yes, of course, because too much polygons now. As you can see, all my landscape have this grass. But if you push, if you connect our camera and make enable clip camera Frustum, and you can see our grass coming only on camera view. All other area we no need. But additionally, we no need in this area because it's very far and we cannot see behind the mount. So we are going far clip distance and reduce maybe, I don't know, maybe 3000. Just check. And look what is going on. Come on. Okay, maybe 2000. Ah, yeah, okay, far clip. I forget to enable this button. I forget, sorry. Okay, 3000. Like this. Check what we have. Okay, very nice. And now we are going to increase our multi-flora. Maybe we will do... Where is this? Ah, okay, we're going to distribution and geometry. And we increase until we haven't see this... landscape. Everything should be in grass. So I increase maybe 50,000. Enter and wait. If you have low computer, you will have too much problems because it's taking too much RAM and taking too much resource of your computer. So just little bit pick up, and you can see here it's without grass. So to fix this problem, going inside, filtering, and maybe increase, maybe just little bit. What we have? Okay, now we have it. So again, multiflora and distribution, and maybe increase little bit more because here and here I see some places without grass. Maybe 60,000. Okay, very good, and maybe 70,000, just to make it too much grass, like a wild area. Okay, so I like it. Now I create some redshift material for my landscape. So going inside and make just, I don't know, just dark green, like this, and take out reflection, just reflection to zero. Very good. And apply this to my landscape. Very nice. What we will do now? Go to multicloner and push this button to avoid any stuck in your viewport. We are going to finish with settings. Now we create a material for my pyramids. This is will be very interesting because we will use additionally displacement. So redshift material, going inside, and now check what we have. First of all, I take texture. I will use some from my desktop. I already prepared some stone. Very good. Apply like diffuse color. Very good. Now we are take some bump from this material. So I take color correction and I take a bump. Color correction and bump. So for what I need color correction, as you saw my previous video, you know, yes, to take grayscale. If I apply like this, just put up and take it and reduce saturation up to zero. Sorry, no, apply like this. Apply like this. I can see my stones coming in grayscale. Very good. So push here. And what I need? I need one more color correct. One more. Inside I put also my texture and I will make it very, very contrast. So go in here and apply contrast up to 1 to make it very, very sharp. You see, like this. For what? This we will use for displacement. Take displacement, put here. Take bump. Very good. two color corrections, we will use one of them for bump and one of them for displacement. And this will be our material. So, my bump I will use to redshift material. Just push inside, overall, bump input. Very good. And displacement I have to put directly to my material. So, push here, hold, and displacement. Very nice. Okay, and just maybe few settings. Go in here and make 0.2 glossiness. Okay, also I will take somewhere from this area and apply. I will use also reflection weights. Okay, will be good. It's very difficult material, yes, maybe, but if you try to follow to my tutorial, very soon you will understood what is going on. Okay, so apply this material to my pyramid, make it cubic, and reduce maybe, I don't know, maybe 50 and 50. So take redshift IPR and check what we have. Okay, my computer little bit stuck, but it's normally because okay, maybe I will stop and I will take out, sorry. You see what is going on, yes? Like I told you, all these grass and trees taken really too much resource. Oh, you see, yes, but it's very beautiful. Okay. Before start, I take out all my Forester plugins and check again. So going inside, open, and what we have looks like very nice, but I like to make some displacement. For this I will add some tag for plane, tag redshift mesh, and what I need only enable this and enable this. And my displacement will come in automatically, as you can see. Yes, looks like very nice. So this is done, and now we will apply. I will show you how to use a redshift environmental, and we create redshift sky. If I render, I will put small screen just somewhere here to show you how it's working. Play and hold. Okay, some sun somewhere we have, and it's illuminate our picture. Going inside to the settings, take sun and go to rotation tool. This blue line showing a direction of the sun. So if I change like this, my sun will be somewhere in this area, you can see. Change like this, my sun will be little bit down. And I like to put sun somewhere here. So you have to little bit play, maybe like this. Okay, as you can see, here we have sun. So I very like this position of the sun. And what I will do now, sun done, multiflora, everything done, I have to create some bird. For this, it's very simple to do it, just fake bird. I just go in and create some cylinder. I will do solo view of this cylinder. Change maybe X rotation. What is this? Okay. Cylinder will be very small size, maybe only 10, maybe 5. And lens will be like this, maybe only 2. And I take out segments. I will use only 10 segments and 3 like this. So now going and make it editable. And how, what, okay. And additionally, I create some plane. Some plane will be also very small. I no need very big plane, maybe like this. maybe only 10 centimeter, maybe 15. Okay, 15 centimeters, and maybe like this, 70 maximum. It will be like fake bird. If you like, you can do it. If you don't like, it's not necessary. It's absolutely up to you. What is this? Why it's not working? I not understood. Okay, because very big sizes. This is normal. Just apply little bit lines, maybe 4 lines here, and I don't need more. Okay, make it editable our spline and cylinder. Going inside, selection tools, take it, just make like this. Very good. Select tools, take it and make it like this, and maybe just push somewhere here, so like small fly. Yeah, okay, very good. Select both of them, Alt J on your keyboard, and we give bird name bird. Very good. What we will do now, going to my viewport and put somewhere up, somewhere close to pyramids. For what I need it, just to check a size of this bird. Where is this bird? Here. Yeah, okay, it is directly or not. Yes, looks like directly. So very nice size. Maybe I just little bit reduce size, maybe 0.8. Okay, now I like this size. So take this bird and put inside in the cloner. Go settings of cloner, use a grid array, and I think it's enough. It's enough. Okay, and go to MoGraph Effector and apply random to my cloner. Inside and random, what I need first of all, increase size. Oh, it's too much. Maybe I will use only 500 and 500 like this. Good. Maybe I will use also 100 here. Go to scale, change the size of some birds, and go to rotation. Okay, very good. I think I reduce a size just little bit, maybe 0.8 also of my cloner, and take these birds and put somewhere close to pyramid. No, anyway, it's very, very big. I have to reduce. Okay, like this, and increase effector for random. Okay, very good. I think now it will be good. So I have also some birds. And finally, apply back all my elements, going back to all my trees, and set up render levels up to 5. Very good. Going to settings, and what we have maximum samples, make it about like this to make a very good quality of picture. And finally, I like to use also a camera tag, a redshift camera tag. In this area I will use a bokeh, and I will use exposure. maybe only 4 will be like this, and vignette, no, I don't need vignette, okay. And focus distance to my pyramid, somewhere here. Very good. So now we have to render it. We will save output full and save. We'll save just on the desktop. We will call it pyramid. Very good. Nice. And wait. Now we have to wait a little bit, increase time. Okay, rendering completed. It's taking 3 minutes and 3 seconds. I like this picture. If I increase, I have like nice reflection, stones, displacement, some birds, and too much grass, trees. I have a focus. Okay, what we'll do now, we are going to Adobe After Effects and just take my pyramid and put inside. Okay, from the pyramid we create a new composition. New composition. What we will do now? For this pyramid we will apply a Video Copilot optical flare. I will go to options, lights, and I like this evening sun because our sun going down. For lens texture I will use a dirty. Like this. Okay. And on the original, push somewhere here. Very good. Additionally, I will create new adjustment layer, going to effects and use some magic bullet suit color correction. Magic bullet looks, I don't know, I will use maybe something from Worm. Okay, why not, I like it. Maybe this, no, this, I like it. Okay, very nice. Apply and vignette. Okay, I have vignette. Maybe just little bit increase amount and make focus only on my this area. All other I no need. Only this area. Okay, good. Good, very nice. So my tutorial is completed. If you like it, please subscribe, please share to your friends, put like, and see you in my next tutorial. Goodbye, friends.